Hey fellow problem solvers, Colfax Math here. In this video, it's gonna go over the ASVAB math knowledge test. This ASVAB test is a standardized math test. It's a placement test for the military. It kind of is gonna determine, you know, your career pathway in the military. Doing well on this test is not knowing a lot of math, but understanding how to do standardized math tests. So I'm gonna go through this. What I'd highly recommend you do is you go to the link in the description, print this test out. You do it first and then watch how I do it. Or you might even want to only do 3 or 4 problems and then unpause the video and watch how I do those 3 or 4 problems. So again, this is section 5, mathematical knowledge. You do not need to know some of the rules of math. And if it's been a while, videos like this might really help refresh. Okay, so a couple of strategies I do. You know, it's a time test. It's about a minute per problem. So if you're spending a lot of time on it, you want to move on and get to one you can do, and then go back if there's time at the end. And speaking to that, you want to mark up the test as much as you can, so if you go back, all your work's already there. You also want to mark up the test as much as you can so you don't make any careless mistakes. So pause the video, do a few problems, and watch how I do them. Okay, number one, this problem right here is really about order of operations. It's giving you a value of x. X is equal to 8. You got to take that value and plug it in there. So that means you're going to have 8 squared divided by 4. You have to do exponents before division. 64 divided by 4, I'm going to cut it in half to get 32. Cut that in half to get 16. Then I have 16 minus 2, or 14. So there's my answer right there. The cube of 5 is, well, cube is a 3D object. It's going to have a height, a width, and a depth. Each one of these is 5. So I think it's asking for the volume here. So 5 times 5, 25. Times 5, 125. So answer 2. On to number 3. Again, order of operations. 3 cubed is 3 times 3, 9 times 3, 27. So this thing right here is 27 times 2.5. Now, even before I do that, I'm just going to look at my answers and see if any make sense. So 27 times 2 is about 50, more than 50, so it can't be that one, and it can't be that one. But I'm not sure which one of these it is, so I think I will multiply it out. 5 times 7, 35. 10, 13. 2 times 7, 14. Carry the 1, 4, 5. And then I'm going to add those 5, 7, 6. I have my decimal place 1 unit over, 67.5. 75 was too high, I probably could have eliminated that one. The fourth root of 16 is, well, that's saying what times itself, times itself, times itself is equal to 16. Or what to the fourth power is equal to 16. So you probably run that in your head pretty quick. If you're trying 4, 4 times 4, 16, it can't be that. It has to be less than 4. 3 is an odd number. 3, 9, that's not going to work. 1's not going to work. So 2 is the only one that's going to work. 2 times 2, 4. Times 2, 8. Times 2, 16. Number 5 here, I don't think there are any tips or tricks to this. You just need to know this in math. The general equation is y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope. M is defined as a rise, which is going to be the difference in the y values, over the run, the difference in the x values. So there's a lot of math knowledge you need to know here. So I'm going to use these 2 points to find my slope first. My slope is going to be y2, 3, minus y1, divided by x2, which is 2, minus x1. So I'm calling this my first point, x1, y1. My second point, x2, y2. X always comes before y, and they're an ordered pair. So I have 3 minus a negative 1. That's going to actually turn it into a plus. Minus a negative is a plus. That's 4. 2 minus 0 is 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. So my slope is 2. So m here is 2. I have y equals 2x plus b. I can eliminate these two answers. So I know it has to be one or the other there. If I have enough time to keep going, then I'm going to just take any point, a point with a zero in it, it'll be much easier. I'm going to take that x and that y and plug it in to solve. So I have y equals mx plus b, but I know m is 2, so y equals 2x plus b. I'm going to take this point right here, plug that 0 in for x, that negative 1 in for y. Negative 1 equals 2 times 0 plus b. This is 0, so b is equal to negative 1. So I have a slope of 2, a y-intercept of negative 1. There it is right there, so it's answer A. Okay, number 6 right here. I have yards and feet. I'm going to have to do a unit conversion, either convert yards to feet or feet to yards, 3 feet to the yard. Before I even do that, I'm looking at my answers. I could see 3 of my answers are in feet and only 1 are in yards, so I'm going to convert everything into feet. Most likely, answer is going to be in feet. I'm going to take that 12 yards, multiply it by 3 feet to get a total of 36 feet, plus those 14 feet will give me a total of 50 feet. Divided by 5 will give me 10 feet. So there's my answer right there, 10 feet. And it was a good guess to go to feet instead of yards because of those 3 answers right there. Looking for these tips and tricks really help a lot, and doing practice really helps a lot. So if you're not doing these problems before me, pause the video and make sure you do them before I do them. Okay, number 7 here, x to the third times x to the fourth. This is just a check to see if you know the rules of exponents. If I have x to the m times x to the n, I add those exponents together to get x to the m plus n, and that's what I'm doing here. X to the third times x to the fourth, I add them together to get x to the seventh. So if you don't remember that, review the rules of exponents. Those are pretty key. Number 8, this is about expanding quadratic. So I have a quantity x plus 4 times a quantity x plus 2. Some people use the acronym FOIL to remember that. And what that means is you multiply the first terms together, x times x is x squared. The outer terms together, x times 2 is 2x. The inner terms together, 4x. And then L, the last, is the last terms together. 4 times 2 is 8. So I have x squared, 2x plus 4x is 6x. Plus 8, and I have x squared plus 6x plus 8 right here, answer D. Number 9, this is pretty much about place value. I could just go 1.5 times 10 to the third and move this over 1, 2, 3. So I move my decimal place over 1, 2, 3, 3 places with the 10 to the third, and I come up with 1500. Which of the following is a prime number? 27 could be divisible by 3, 8 divisible by 2, 4 divisible by 2. So 11 is the prime. Again, kind of a vocab problem, but nothing will go into 11, and that's why it's a prime number. Number 11, what's the mode of the following set of data? Again, that's a vocab question. There's mean, median, and mode. The mean is the average value, add all the values up and divide by the number of values. The median, like the median on the freeway, is the middle value. And the mode is the most frequent value. So which one appears most frequently? I'm going to look here. There are 2 4s, 3 8s, 2 10s, 2 12s. So 8 is the mode. There are more values of 8 than any other value. Again, a vocab question. This one, number 12. Again, is a test on the rules of exponents. You could plug 4 in first, but it's going to be a lot more computation. If I do a to the third divided by a, well, that's really a to the first. If I know the rules of exponents, I subtract in division to get a squared. I take that 4 and I plug it in there. 4 times 4 is 16, answer D. So the rules of exponents with division is x to the m divided by x to the n. I keep that base number of x, and then m minus n. So that's where I got the 3 minus 1 from. Okay, I'll just do 3 more problems here, and then I'll do the rest of the test in a separate video. If you're new to this channel, think about subscribing. It's Colfax Math. It's math with a purpose, practical math. It's really about solving problems. I have a merchandise Colfax Math shirt in the description if you're interested in that. Think about buying one and support the channel. Okay, so number 13 here, 5, that exclamation point does not mean 5. It means 5 factorial, which is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. 5 times 4 is 20, times 3 is 60, times 2 is 120. So 5 factorial is 120. Number 14, order of operations, parentheses before division. 9 times 2 is 18, plus those two zeros on the end. So 900 times 2 is 1800, divided by 6. 6 can go into 18 three times, and then 0, 0. So the answer is 300, or answer B. And then 15 here, if x is equal to 2, you have to take that 2 and plug it in and know your order of operations as well. So I'm going to plug 2 in for x to get 2 to the power of 2 times 2. Exponents before multiplication, so I have 4 times 2, or 8. The order of operations, sometimes you use this right here, PEMDAS, which means parentheses get done first, then exponents, then multiplication, division, then addition, subtraction, in order from left to right. Okay, if you're new to the channel, think about subscribing. I'm hoping this helped. I do know the more you practice, the better you do. So if you're taking the ASVAB, make sure you watch some videos, do some practice tests, try and simulate the actual test, so no calculator, kind of be time, sit in a quiet space, and just do the best you can, and just keep practicing, and doing well on that ASVAB will have a big impact on your military career. So put the time in up front, and it'll pay dividends. All right, thank you for watching. Please comment below. I'd love to hear how you're doing, how your preparations are going, and how you ended up doing on the ASVAB. And all the watchers of these videos would love to hear your feedback on taking that ASVAB. So please post those in the comments.